Having pronounced, they were now saying it themselves. They said, having pronounced the existing education system is clinically dead, because once this reorientation rewiring was done with new vocabulary and evidence to show that their system was dead, the Ghanaian government now was saying it themselves, our system is dead. So they were now preparing for the onward march in the other direction. So a wide-ranging education reform was now promulgated together with the BEC, to now be implemented in that direction. Under that new IMF World Bank tutelage, the reform proposals were announced very abruptly and was developed in the absence of any policy analysis and with the knowledge of a very limited number of people. When they come around to talk of good governance, you should cut their necks. Because, it really sucks. As my children use that word. Who has teenage children? Mom, it really sucks. Okay. The political environment in the education sector within which those reform policies were being promulgated was tense. This is in Ghana. The Ghana Education Service Council, the body which had the final authority in the appointments, disciplines, and other professional matters in the Ghana Education Service, got abolished. And a new law at the time replaced that body with a kind of education commission which had only advisory powers. All the powers of the proscribed council became vested in the Secretary of Education. Thus, professionals enjoyed no protective cover, no single officer was too strong to be dealt with if he or she stood in the way of the ministry in this new dispensation. The period following this law witnessed numerous dismissals, interdictions, redeployments, premature retirements of all of those staff that used to run the system of education. For example, regional directors who told pressmen they had not received enough textbooks and equipment when the government in fact claimed they had were immediately dismissed, retired, transferred, or demoted for incompetence. This situation created fear among professionals who buried their reservations and refrained from comments that would be interpreted as counter to the new reform. And it affected directors at nearly every level of the ministry. Their silence thereafter and the silence of others led to a breakdown in communications between the regional, district, and institutional directors on the one hand and the ministry officials at the other hand. And by failing to report that regional, district, and institutional directors what they faced, government created the impression that all was in fact ready for takeoff. Do you see? The silence that had been induced was now interpreted in this new king's piece to say silence means everything is okay. We just added insult to injury. The rest are in the paper. At some point when I finish the paper, maybe you can circulate or something. Guinea signed an agreement with the IMF based on a financial and monetary program. The essential elements of this agreement were, as with all adjusting countries, controlling employment and consumption, improving investment programs, the familiar list. Now, after the military coup in 1984, the new government had accelerated the negotiations with donors. In 1986, an adjustment program was launched. Its objective was to remove the state first from the productive arena, blah, 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 the usual recipe. And so, and during that same year, with support from the bank, the government began two projects, Educations 1 and 2. Their objective was to improve the operation of certain key elements of the education system, etc. But if you look closely, although the results of these projects in isolation seem positive, they had no substantive factor because they were not part of any coherent policy sector framework and did not address the need for change in the existing strategy. By the end of 1989, preparations for the sector program were already underway. By that time, a new thinking had been consolidated in the context of this project to the effect that experience in other countries, meaning the other adjusting countries, had shown that a coherent policy framework linked to macro adjustment can lead to changes in education sector, meaning